Welcome back. We now have today's numbers for Algoma. We have tested 405 people, we have 5 positive tests, and we have 224 negative tests, and we're waiting for test results for 176. Now, these were the numbers they released at 8:30 this morning. However, we do know there's one other case in Algoma, so that number has gone up to 6. Here's what we can tell you about the first 5. The first case was a woman in her 50s. The second case is a female in her 40s. The third case was a male in his 60s. The fourth case is a female in her 60s. And finally, case 5 was a 20-year-old male as well. He was the first person in Algoma region under the age of 40 to actually get COVID-19. Nationally speaking, about 33% of everyone who gets COVID-19 happens to be in the age group of under 40. Now, one of the most vulnerable age groups is in seniors' homes. We are now up to 29 dead in Ontario nursing and retirement homes in the province. What we do know from officials is that there is at least 22 facilities across Ontario that are seniors' homes that have outbreaks of COVID-19. This is raising fears across the province that the pandemic is going to really affect the seniors' long-term care homes and then also the nursing homes. What we do know is that there is now 29 dead at nursing homes across the province. These 29 dead include the 12 that we know of from a nursing home in Bobcaygeon. We're seeing an outbreak in the nursing homes across the province, with 22 nursing homes currently facing an outbreak of COVID-19. We do know that we have 40 deaths now across Ontario related to COVID-19 and about 107 nationwide. Dr. Barbara Yaffe, who is the Associate Chief Medical Officer of Health for Ontario, said Tuesday afternoon that 11 deaths in Ontario were in long-term care homes. However, she acknowledged that figure isn't up to date. We know that there was 12 dead at a Bobcaygeon nursing home, and one of the volunteers passed away there as well, which leaves 17 other COVID-related deaths in long-term care and retirement homes across the province. Now, Natalie Mehra, who is the Executive Director of the Ontario Health Coalition, said the following: "It's heartbreaking because people in those homes are very vulnerable. Now, it's a serious and deadly disease that I am frightened for what's going to happen across Ontario's long-term care homes now." Now, the virus is not necessarily just spread by people within the nursing home. It's also spread by staff and visitors. Now, most nursing and retirement homes have asked that non-essential visitors do not come to the nursing homes at all. The staff are now being screened 24/7. The Ontario government put in a policy just a few days ago that there's 24/7 screening for all staff going into any long-term care or nursing home in the province. Now, based on new research from the Center for Disease Control in America, people who are doing asymptomatic transmission of the virus, which means that you have it but you don't know you have it and you're giving it to others, is a problem in the nursing and long-term care homes. And what they're now suggesting is that all staff in long-term care homes and nursing homes wear masks all the time to try and prevent the spread of COVID-19 through what is the most vulnerable population for this outbreak. And we're already seeing that 22 nursing homes across this province are having outbreaks of COVID-19. We need to slow that down and stop it, and masks are one way to do it. We'll be right back.